Hey basketball players, today I'm going to talk to you about how you can play point guard in basketball. So let's get down to it. Okay, so what are some of the things that a point guard does in basketball? So number one, obviously, he's the player who dribbles the ball up the court, so you're going to need to have some ball handling skills. Number two, he is going to be hopefully a shooter, because if he can't shoot, then what's going to happen to him is just what happens to Simmons, which means that the defender sags off and he loses a lot of different passing lanes because his defender is sagging off and daring him to shoot the ball. So you're going to need to be able to shoot the ball at a high level, because that is what brings the defender close, so you can stretch out the defense so that you can make more passes, which then leads me into being able to pass the ball. Passing the ball is very important for a point guard, because that is his job. He is the coach on the court. He needs to be able to see what the defense is doing and where his players are, so that he can get his players the shots that they need and in the areas that they need to be able to score. So unless you're getting pressured, you should really be able to see what the defense is doing by the time you hit half. As soon as you hit half, unless they were running a press defense against you, you need to be able to see if they're playing zone or man-to-man. And depending on the team, one of those is going to be easier to see than the other. Now, going from there, if they're running a zone, you better be running a zone offense. If they're running a man, you better be running a man offense. So the point guard not only has to be able to be good at ball handling, passing, and shooting, he also needs to be one of the smartest players on the court. And now we're going to be moving over to the most important part of being a point guard, and that is defense. You need to be able to defend usually the fastest player on the other team. That is usually where I stick my point guards, because usually the point guard is the fastest position on the court. Usually, not always, but usually. So what does this mean? You need to have fast feet. It's not about how fast you can run in a straight line. It's about how fast you can change direction. So it's a little bit different from track, where you can say, hey, I'm the fastest in school. You can be the fastest in school, but you can be really slow on the basketball court. You need to have fast feet. And how do you get fast feet? Agility drills. You can get an agility ladder, or you can use the side of the key like this. So here we have the side of the key, and what can we do to the side of the key to allow us to have faster feet? Well, number one, we can do a quick scissor drill, which is just one foot in front of the other all the way along the side of the key, and you want to try and go as fast as you can. Another one that you can do is to do almost like a karaoke move along this line. You always want to be on your toes for this, and you want to cross your feet in front and then behind all the way along that line. This is going to help you have faster feet in basketball. There's a few others as well. If you're younger, again, still on your toes, doing 2 feet jumps, what we call hopscotch, along that line. Now, agility drills are great for offense and defense. For offense, it's going to allow you to drive past your defender a lot faster, but on defense, it's going to allow you to keep up with your player much easier. Now, going into shooting. Shooting is very important. To have a good three-point shot, or even a deep two-point mid-range shot, what you'd be looking to do is to keep your elbow underneath that ball. It doesn't matter if your shot is way back here like Luka Doncic, or up like this, like somebody like Klay Thompson. And as long as the shoulder and elbow are pointing towards the rim and this part of your arm is straight up, you're going to have a straight shot. Now, of course, there's more into shooting a ball than just that, but I do go into further in depth in about probably 50 other videos on this channel. So definitely go check those out. If I remember, I'll link them in the cards up top. And then what a point guard is really used for is passing and dribbling. Those are the two most important and most used skills of a point guard. So number one, if you want to be able to pass better, create a couple of targets. So you can use a fence and stick up a target. You can use a cement brick wall or whatever and put up some targets, or just try to aim for a cross on one of those brick walls in like the YMCA gym and try to hit that target with two-hand passes, but also one-hand passes. We really want to work on our one hand, because there's a reason for that. if you come up and you're about to do a one-hand pass, but that now is covered, you can then dribble again. While with a two-handed pass, if you pick it up to pass, you can't dribble again. So now, if you're gonna pass to somebody over there and then you can't, you can just bring it right back down. As long as your hand doesn't go below the bottom half of this ball, you're all set. So now, what you can do as a player is do a couple of stationary dribbling drills while trying to hit a target with a pass. And what I mean by this is you could do a quick one-handed crossover through the legs, and then pass with the left hand and try to hit a target. And then you can keep on going. You could have two ball dribbling. So you can be dribbling two balls at the same time. And then your coach, parent, trainer, whoever could go and say right hand pass. And what you're gonna do is dribble, dribble, dribble with two balls, right hand pass, get it back, dribble again. There's so many different drills that you can do. But basically any dribbling drill that you have ever done in your life, you can also add in a target and try to hit that target as well, get that ball back and continue dribbling drills. Now, I hope that this video has helped you become a better point guard. If it has, hit that like button and subscribe, and I will see you guys again next time.